Elon Musk is by far the greatest inventor of our time. But it's easy to be blinded by his fortune, his ambitious plans to conquer Mars, electrify cars, develop artificial intelligence, take over Twitter and whatnot. And whether you idolize him or breathe a sigh of relief whenever you don't hear about him for a week, there's something you should learn from him. And that's his way of thinking creatively and solving problems. In this video, you'll also learn about a law that has predicted car production costs for over 100 years and now affects Tesla's costs as well. Elon Musk has developed a way of thinking that allows him to revolutionize industries that seem untouchable to most people. And in this video, I'm going to explain as precisely as I can, step by step, how this thinking process works. Most people are either not creative at all, or if they are creative, they think in analogies.
Through most of our life, we get through life by reasoning by analogy, which essentially means kind of copying what other people do with slight variations.
Innovating by analogy works like this. For example, Flickr came up with an online platform to share photos. YouTube then pitched its idea as, "We are the Flickr for videos." And then SoundCloud used the same analogy and pitched its business idea as, "We are the Flickr for music." As you can see with this example, you can also develop great innovations by analogy. But that's not the way Elon Musk solves problems. And that's why his ideas are different. Elon's innovative thinking is based on a combination of Wright's law and first principles thinking. You may have heard Elon Musk talk about first principle thinking in other videos, but may not have fully understood how he applies it for innovation. That's because we first need to understand Wright's law, where Elon's thinking process starts. In the year 1936, Theodore Wright, an aeronautical engineer, made an interesting observation. He was studying the cost of making airplanes. The more airplanes his company built, the more process improvements they discovered and the more they learned. The optimized processes allowed them to make airplanes cheaper and faster. When Wright quantified the impact of this learning on cost reduction, he found that costs were constantly falling. Every time the number of cumulative aircraft produced doubled, costs dropped by a constant rate. Wright's observation became known as Wright's law. It's important to note, though, that this is a cumulative amount. Consequently, the longer a product has been in production already, looking at you gasoline cars, the more difficult it becomes to double the total quantity produced. But what effect does Wright's law have on Tesla, the car company Elon Musk is running? Actually, that's pretty amazing. Tesla has a cumulative production volume of 3 million electric cars as of today in the summer of 2022. That is, in the 19 years since its foundation, they have just produced 3 million cars. But in the meantime, they have ramped up their production.
We've already been able to achieve a 1.5 million unit annualized run rate.
That means that even if Tesla would stop growing today, it would only need 2 years to double its total production volume. Accordingly, Elon Musk can be very confident that the cost of Tesla's cars and batteries will continue to come down just through further incremental optimizations at the rate of Wright's law. But Elon's thinking process doesn't stop at Wright's law. In fact, it's the starting point of his thinking. Whether it's batteries, solar panels or rockets, Elon Musk has always questioned how the price of something is fundamentally made up.
So let's say you're trying to figure out why is this part or product expensive? Is it because of something fundamentally foolish that we're doing, or is it because our volume is too low? And so then you say, okay, well, what if our volume was 1 million units a year? Is it still expensive? That's what I mean by thinking about things in the limit. If it's still expensive at 1 million units a year, then volume is not the reason why your thing is expensive. There's something fundamental about the design.
Tesla's mission is not to build as many cars as possible, but to accelerate the transition to sustainable energy in the world. So instead of watching the cost of batteries following Wright's law, Elon is asking himself, can this evolution be influenced? He's convinced that all laws except the laws of physics can be broken.
Yeah, I like saying like physics is a law and everything else is a recommendation. Mm-hmm. I've met a lot of people who can break the law, but I haven't met anyone who could break physics.
Wright's law describes the result of incremental innovation in manufacturing, while first principle thinking enables radical innovation. First principle thinking is one of the best ways to explore complicated problems and unleash creative possibilities. The idea behind it is to break down complicated problems into their basic elements and then reassemble them from scratch. This approach goes back to the Greek philosopher Aristotle, who defined first principles as the first basis from which a thing is known. Here's how Elon explains first principle thinking.
My first principles is kind of a physics way of looking at the world. And what that really means is you kind of boil things down to the most fundamental truths and say, okay, what are we sure is true or as sure as possible is true? And then reason up from there.
Let's look at a specific example of how Elon Musk is using first principle thinking to further lower the price of batteries, fulfill Tesla's mission, and break Wright's law.
And we need to do something about this curve. This curve, the curve of the cost per kilowatt hour of batteries is not improving fast enough. So we've given this a lot of thought over many years to say, okay, how can we radically improve the cost per kilowatt hour curve?
The question Elon and his team at Tesla asked themselves using reasoning from first principles was, what is the fundamental composition of the cost of batteries? The result was five components that influence the price: cell design, cell factory, anode materials, cathode materials, and cell vehicle integration. Starting from the problem that the cost of batteries is not coming down fast enough, even in spite of Wright's law, they looked at the whole chain from raw material extraction to battery integration into the car. For example, the process optimization alone, how nickel is mined and processed for the batteries, yielded huge cost savings and efficiency improvements.
And these things just grew up as just they're just kind of like legacy things that it's like how it was done before. And then they connected the dots, but really didn't think of the whole thing from like a first principle standpoint, saying how do we get from the nickel ore in the ground to the finished nickel product for a battery. And so we've looked at the entire value chain and said, how can we make this as simple as possible?
Overall, innovation in all parts of the value chain of batteries can achieve cost reductions of over 50% and a sustainable change in the cost curve for the dollar per kilowatt hour.
Enables us to do is achieve a new trajectory in the reduction of cell cost.
And while Elon Musk doesn't recommend thinking in analogies, he loves using analogies to explain ideas. For example, he explains the new battery integration with this analogy.
So all modern airplanes, the fuel tank, your wing is just a fuel tank in wing shape. This is absolutely the way to do it. And then the fuel tank serves as dual structure. And it's no longer cargo, it's fundamental to the structure of the aircraft. This was a major breakthrough. We're doing the same for cars.
First principles thinking can be fundamentally applied to any question and any problem. But in terms of revolutionizing industries, Elon Musk's thought process can be summed up like this. If something is too expensive, how would the cost evolve if we would produce 10 times, 100 times, or even 1,000 times more of it? Or in other words, how does Wright's law behave for that thing? If it is still expensive, what can it be? What are the costs of raw materials, design, processes, etc.? How can we reduce costs and increase scalability simultaneously by replacing raw materials, changing the design, integrating, simplifying, reusing, etc.? How can all these partial innovations be combined into holistic innovation? And how can we use analogies to explain what we did? Wright's law describes the effect of incremental innovation on cost, while first principle thinking enables radical innovation. While most business leaders stop at incremental innovation, Elon is trying to understand the fundamental truths, which enables him to find more creative solutions. If you enjoyed this video, feel free to give it a like, a hug, a high five, subscribe, or post it on your favorite Elon Musk fan subreddit. Think about it. And don't forget to click the notification bell, and I'll remind you whenever a new video is coming out about the psychology of innovation.